Setiap kali Ramadan, perang buffet akan melanda dengan pelbagai promosi dan menu yang ditawarkan. Dengan adanya media sosial, kerja promosi makin senang. Harga satu kepala buka pula bukan calang-calang, malah ada yang mencecah RM350. Bagi B40 dan M40 pasti terfikir harga tidak logik dan hanya mampu tengok. Kita ikuti laporan yang disediakan wartawan Afizia Zaman.
Selak saja media sosial pasti bersusun promosi bufet Ramadan. Harga satu kepala bagi dewasa di hotel antara RM88 hingga RM350, manakala restoran pula dari RM65 hingga RM300. Tidak dinafikan ada peningkatan harga bufet Ramadan sama ada di hotel mahupun restoran.
Significant. There's a big difference between what we price ourselves pre-COVID and now. I would say it's close to maybe almost a 40% difference between what we price ourselves pre-COVID and now. Post-COVID, of course, we've had to deal with a lot of increases in costs. Everything from utilities all the way up to manpower. So, and year on year, from last year to this year, we had to make up to about 8% in terms of growth.
Dari segi tahun lepas dan sekarang, memang kita tak naikkan harga yang setinggi. Kalau kita katakan dalam harga, mungkin tak melebihi 10%. Tapi anggaran tu untuk tahun lepas dengan perbezaan tu lebih kurang, kalau kita kata anggaran tu 5% sahaja kebanyakannya.
Yes, there is a price change for buffet Ramadan this year with an increment of 10% compared to last year.
Bagi yang mampu, mungkin harga bukan masalah jika dibandingkan dengan kepelbagaian juadah, rasa yang enak dan persekitaran yang eksklusif. Bagi yang kurang berkemampuan, perlu ada analisis bajet, apatah lagi kalau ramai ahli keluarganya. Bagi penyedia perkhidmatan pula, mereka tidak menafikan kenaikan yang berlaku tetapi ia terpaksa dilakukan.
This increase due to factors such as higher prices for goods, product and as well as services. We also added food variety in the Ramadan buffet spread itself. It's also contributed by the changing of consumer patterns, where they have more options for them to select, including from the hotels as well as from other restaurants.
Berkenaan dengan kos-kos yang berkenaan dengan inflasi, harga-harga kos yang kita imported food kan, maknanya dari, kalau kita beli daging dari luar negara, kos tu berkenaan dengan inflasi lah.
A lot of it has to do with utilities, raw material. Whilst we may not, it may not have impacted us SST wise. There is some impact from the utilities point of view, from manpower point of view, the gig economy. You know, where they want to come in, they don't want to be committed to one particular organization for too long. It's almost a hit and run. And we've seen. You know, I think for a long time we were paying, like I was mentioning earlier, casual workers we were paying on average ten to twelve ringgit pre-COVID. Now they are up to 15. In some cases where there's a huge demand around this area, hotels are paying up to 20 per hour. And it's hard to compete. It's hard to compete at that level. That eats into our expenses as well.
Apapun harga yang ditetapkan, pilihan terletak di tangan pelanggan. Mungkin ada yang menganggap tidak salah sesekali berbelanja lebih untuk dinikmati ahli keluarga sempena Ramadan. Apa yang penting adalah bajet perlu dibuat lebih awal sebelum musim perayaan, kerana sememangnya kali ini cabaran ekonomi semasa tidak mudah dengan peningkatan kos terhidup yang ketara.